Guys, put your GM hats on. What would you do with that second pick? Or what should Joe Douglas do with that second pick?
I mean, if I'm staying at the second pick, I would take Penei Sewell, too. I think he's the next slam dunk. And again, I'm on the team Sam Darnold here. I would stick with him at quarterback. But I think that number two pick is really for a quarterback, and it's for somebody else. I think you trade down, and then you've got options. There are other offensive linemen. There are some really good cornerbacks. You know, you could take a receiver. There's about three or four, or, you know, Kyle Pitts at tight end. There's a lot of weapons that are up there, too. So if you trade down to eight, say at Carolina, it gives you a lot of other options of what you can look at. And, you know, for the Jets, it's just too much value to hold on to that pick. You got to trade it to somebody.
Bart, what should Joe do?
Well, for me, it depends, right? I'm either going to 4 or 8. And if I go to 4, that means I'm still going to jump in front of Cincinnati and I'm going to take Sewell. You think about all the successful teams. What are everybody trying to do? They're trying to get two great tackles to be able to protect their quarterbacks from the outside and allow them to be able to have a good pocket to be able to survey the field, right? So we always talk about, oh, these are how teams win. Teams win because they protect their quarterback, give them the opportunity to go through the process and allow guys to get open. And I think the Jets have an opportunity to do that. Now, can they still do that in free agency? Yes, they can. They still got the 23rd pick. They probably can give that to Baltimore, bring in Orlando Brown Jr., which I've been speaking about for the last 3 months. They still have opportunity to be able to do that. Or they can go the veteran route. They can go and try and see if Fisher can get healthy or Swartz can get healthy and say, hey, let's see if we can bet on these guys, you know, being available later in the season, you know, off the PUP. Squad or something like that, but I'm definitely dropping back. If I drop back to 8 with Carolina, I'm going to get more picks. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get a second, a third. I'm going to get next year's first-round draft pick after the swap, but then I'm telling myself then, okay, well, if I'm doing that, then that means I'm trying to go for a corner or another position. If you want the best tackle in the game, a slam dunk, then you have to go for Sewell. You can't be any farther than Cincinnati's pick. If you want to go Pitts or a great pass receiver or something like that, somebody can work the middle, then you trade with Carolina.
And Joe Douglas, he's an offensive line guy, and he told Sam Darnold's parents two seasons ago, I'm going to do everything I can to protect your son. So
I just hope it ain't protecting your son by sending him to another team.